This is part two on working with the slope of a line, and we're going to just do some more practice by looking at a graph, computing the exact slope of the line. So the first thing to notice is the slant of the line. This is like going downhill. If you go from left to right, as your eyes move from left to right, and remember this is going to be a negative slope. So if you keep that in mind, it's going to be a negative slope, then when you're done with your problem, make sure that your answer is negative. All right, so what we could do is start from any point on the line and figure out how to get to another point on the line. Remember, it doesn't matter where you start and where you end as long as those two points are on the line. Let's go ahead and start right here. Okay, and let's say we want to end over here. All right, how would I get from that point to the other point? Now, if you'd like to do the rise going up or down first and then the run, that's fine. I just, from habit, always do the denominator first. I do the run first. I go left or right first. So I first have to go to the right. How many blocks or how many spaces? All right, if I count them very carefully, that's 4 plus 4 more. I've got 8 spaces and I'm going to the right. So in the run, the x value is 8, the x coordinate, if you want to think of it. Actually, not the x coordinate, just the run, the change in x. And now I'm going to go down, right? That's going to be my rise, even though I'm going down. Down means it's negative 2. So that's going to be negative 2. And now we simplified. Remember, the slope is just a number. It's negative 1/4. So the slope of this line is negative 1/4. Now, let's try it between two other points. So let's pick a couple other points and do exactly the same thing. See if I can get rid of the. Okay. So here we are. I've got the line again. And let's go between these two points. And remember, it doesn't matter where you start and where you end. So let's say I'm going to start at this one that's on the y-axis and I need to get over to the left. So how am I going to do that? First, I've got to go to the left. How many spaces? Negative 4. So this time, in the x direction, the run, I'm going negative 4 spaces. And then I'm going up one space to get to that point. So it's plus 1, and that also reduces to negative 1/4. It doesn't matter what two points you use, this is going to keep happening. The slope of this line is going to be negative 1/4. So we'll try another line now. Here's another one. I want you to figure out the slope of the line. I didn't draw this line exactly perfectly, but hopefully you can see the little dot. So go ahead and put the video on pause and see if you what you get for the slope of this line. You could do the rise over run between any two points. Okay, there's lots of ways to do it. Let's say I just pick this point and this point. I'm going over two spaces and I'm going up two spaces. So the slope, well, they're both 2, right? 2 over 2 is going to be 1. So hopefully you got a slope of 1. Remember, it's just a number. Ready for another one? So it's easier to see the points. I'm actually not going to draw the line, but imagine you have a line going through the four points I've shown here. So there are different ones you can go from. You've got 0, 5, another order pair here is 1, 2, another order pair is 2, negative 1, and another one is 3, negative 4. So pick two points, doesn't matter, and figure out how would you get from one point to the other. Put it on pause and try it. First of all, I hope you notice that this line is going to be like going downhill as you look from left to right. So the slope is going to be negative. So hopefully you'll notice that when you're done that you got a negative number. All right, let's pick these two points in the middle here. I want to go from here to here. How would I get there? I would have to go in the x direction, positive 1. And in the y direction, negative 3. So if I was going to do that slope, in the x direction, that goes in the denominator, right? Positive 1 in the y direction, negative 3, that gives me a slope of negative 3. All right, let's say somebody else picked two other points. How about this one up here and this one down here? And let's start at the bottom and try to get up here. So I first have to go to the left. How many spaces? 3 spaces. So I know that's what's going to go in the denominator. And then I got to go up all the way to here. So we count the spaces here. There's 4 plus 5 more. That's 9 spaces. 9 divided by negative 3 is also negative 3. So the slope of this line through those 4 points is a slope of negative 3. So if I had graphed the line carefully, that's hard to do, something like this. That blue line, if it was straight, has a slope of negative 3. Notice that we determined ahead of time that the slope was negative. Slope is less than 0 because it slants the direction which makes it less than 0. So looks like we did it correctly. We did it 2 different ways. All right, how about this horizontal line? Do you remember what the slope of a horizontal line is? We went over it in the previous video. It was 0, but let's verify that. All right, so in other words, you could remember that a horizontal line has slope 0, but it should also work by using our formula of rise over ren. So let's pick two points. Let's pick this point and this point here. All right, so how am I going to get from this point over to that point? Well, first I've got to go over 4 spaces, so I know over, that's what it goes over, 4 spaces is in the denominator, the x, and then I don't go up or down at all, do I? So it's 0, and what's 0 over 4? 0, so we verified it. The slope really is 0. Let's do it for a vertical line. Do you remember what the slope of a vertical line is? It should be undefined. It doesn't equal undefined. You say slope is undefined. All right, but let's verify that. Let's pick two points. How about this point and this point? All right. So the rise, let's do the rise first. In other words, how far up or down? Let's say if I start at the top and I want to get down. I'm going down 5 spaces, right? So in that direction, I'm going down 5. And that's the vertical, the rise goes in the numerator. And then what? How far over left or right am I going? Well, I'm not going left or right at all. And now you got to remember, what's anything divided by 0? Undefined. If you're not sure about that, look at my video about why dividing by 0 is undefined. So that's the conclusion of this video. We were just practicing figuring out the slope of a line by looking at a graph of it. Sometimes it's not so easy and you're just given two points on a line as ordered pairs. So the next video is going to go over how to compute it algebraically without looking at a picture.